I've been working for the NHS for over 15 years now, and it's wonderful because when I get patients sent to me who are overweight or got heart disease or high blood pressure, I can talk to them about all the plant-based foods they can eat that make them a lot healthier by cutting out all the saturated fat and high salt foods in their diet. Wow. Recommendations now by the Department of Health is to go towards a more plant-based diet with the encouragement to have 5 portions of fruits and vegetables a day. In my opinion, omnivores can be lacking in lots of vitamins and minerals and nutrition generally. If you look at the obesity, look at all the fast foods, they're the kind of foods that vegans just wouldn't entertain eating at all. And certainly studies have shown that vegans are less at risk of heart disease, type 2 diabetes, and things like hypertension. So certainly a vegan diet encompasses all those health benefits as well. And I feel really fit and healthy. I love my food and I do love having treats. And the benefits from a vegan diet is that it's low in saturated fat. So you can have all these treats and you know you're still going to be looking after your heart. People often are concerned about calcium, which you can get from fortified foods, and vitamin B12, which you can get through things like fortified non-dairy milks, some soya products, also from some yeast extracts. Whether you're vegan or a meat eater, you still need to make sure you have adequate quantities of vitamin D. The main source comes from sunshine, from the sunlight on your skin. So get adequate sunshine or have fortified foods containing vitamin D. And we get quite a few queries about parents or pregnant women who are concerned about getting the right nutrition for their children and for their unborn child. And certainly we can assure them that they get all the nutrition they need through a planned vegan diet. And I've written a book for the Vegan Society about vegan infants. It starts from conception through to infancy. And hopefully parents are reassured that they can get all the nutrition they need for themselves and for their children.
I've been vegan for 6 years, and when I became pregnant, friends asked me, are you going to stay vegan? Surely not, sort of thing. And I didn't have any pressure from doctors or midwives. Everyone seemed very happy for me to stay vegan. It wasn't a problem at all. I read a lot about being pregnant and I knew everything that I was supposed to be eating, and so it was absolutely fine. I was very active and fit during my pregnancy. Pregnancy was great. I quite enjoyed it. And she was 9 pounds 3 when she was born, so she was a pretty big baby. Without any dairy or meat, you know, I managed to produce a very beautiful, healthy baby, and everything's been great. I've felt very healthy and strong and fit since I've had her. Breastfeeding hasn't been easy. It's made me respect other animals' milk even more and made me feel strongly that I don't want to ingest any other animals' milk, because their milk is meant for their babies, just as my milk is meant for my baby. And it just seems completely wrong that adults of other species should be drinking milk that's not for them. I've been very lucky. I think she's a very happy baby. She's not had colic or any digestive problems. And some people have told me anecdotally they think that's because of my diet, that I'm not eating anything which upsets her digestive system. So I would really advocate staying vegan and being confident about being vegan, because I do believe it's the best thing for your baby as well as for you.